Esteemed Mukhamacharya Mamani sir, Mrs. Anita Venkatachalapathy, Mr. Kannan Sundaram, and friends, seeing this panel at the podium, I have been wondering, in the varisiyale paatha, idhula naan enna pannindu irukkenradhu enakku puriyave illa. Nirmala, the doyen of journalists. Chalapathy has been writing for journals for years. Ramachandra Guha, Srinath Raghavan are historians. Chalapathy is a historian. Krishna is a musician, a prince of culture. Chalapathy has been a spokesman for the meaning of culture, the thingness of culture, the future of culture in the context of India's cultural life, social life. What am I doing here? In seeing Krishna here, I was reminded of the fact கர்நாடக கச்சேரியில் ராகம் தானம் பல்லவின்றது எல்லாம் இருக்கும். ராகம் தானம் பல்லவி எல்லாம் கேட்டிருக்கோம். ஆலாபனை, தனி, தானம், அதுக்கெல்லாம் அதெல்லாம் முடிஞ்சப்பறம் கடைசியில் ஒரு ஒரு துக்கடான்னு ஒன்று வரும். அதுதான் என்னுடைய ரோல் இன்னைக்கு, துக்கடா. ஆனால் அந்த துக்கடான ஆரம்பிக்கும் போது முன்னையெல்லாம் ரொம்ப கர்நாடகமாக அங்கே வந்து ரசிகர்கள் இருக்கிறவங்க துக்கடாலே ஒரு பஜன்னு ஏதாவது அந்த மாதிரி ஏதாவது ஆரம்பிச்ச அவங்க எழுந்து போயிடுவாங்க. ஸோ நீங்கள் இன்னைக்கு நான் என்னுடைய பேச ஆரம்பிக்கும் போது நீங்கள் இன்னும் இங்கேயே இருக்கீங்கிறது எனக்கு ரொம்ப ஆச்சரியமாக இருக்கு. என்னுடைய நன்றி. I just written a few thoughts. Just one sheet. Venkatachalapathy deserves every word of the genuine appreciation, the sincere, grateful thoughts that he has heard today about his learning, his scholarship, his teaching, his writing. And those words have come from scholars, from teachers, writers, and an artist. They come also from across the language divide. In my case, my appreciation of Chalapathy comes not from scholarship or teachership or writership. It comes from very simple rustic friendship of one who admires and is in fact in some awe of Venkatachalapathy for being who and what he is. Learned. Chalapathy is an immensely learned person. His age, his manner belies the fact that he is a profoundly learned person. And yet, he does not keep his learning on his head like some 10 kilo dumbbell. He takes his learning very lightly. He is a scholar without having books pouring out of his words. And he is a teacher without raising his finger constantly in admonition. And he is a writer of writers, who can make his very embarrassed copy editor think that she is actually the author of the book. That is the quality of Chalapathy. His generosity comes from his nature. Used now almost exclusively in the world of classical music for the maestro is a Persian word, ustad, generally signifying maestro. But ustad originally meant not just a master of music, it meant a teacher, one who teaches, imparts learning, and triggers skills as a mentor, like Ashir Mamani is. In the use of human faculties like the voice and limb movements to activate instruments. But it also belonged and still belongs to the world of learning. The last Mughal emperor, Bahadur Shah Zafar, regarded as his ustad, the poet Nasir. Now the Sanskrit vidwan means the same thing, and yet it does not at all mean the same thing. Only in India, only in our country of binaries, of dilemmas, of dichotomies, can you have two words which mean exactly the same thing and yet be totally distinct. Ustad and Vidwan, meaning the same and meaning nothing like the same. Why, how, we cannot say. But usage tells us that. Some polarities are best left unexplored. All one knows is you cannot say Vidwan Vilayat Khan. That would be ridiculous. And you cannot say Ustad Ravi Shankar. That would be monstrous. That is all there is to say. And that is all there is to it. Now, Vidwan, the word, has over time acquired a second gloss, a second meaning, a secondary meaning, meaning wise. And with wisdom, a kind of elevated position, it has the touch of brocade, of jaridhe in it. Vidwan, you imagine some jaridhe floating around it. Now, Pandit is also a synonym of Vidwan. It carries with it something of the fragrance of sandal paste and the movement of Rudraksham beads. But I'm now getting carried away with words, which is a favorite pastime of mine. Chalapati's compilation of Bharati's English letter to the editor of the Hindu, dated 27 December 1904, has the poet describe words, as treacherous. Bharati said, words are treacherous. And Chalapati has rendered that brilliantly. Shudgal, shudgal abattamana vastu. True, absolutely true. Abattamana vastu. Rumba abattu shudgal. So I know when talking of Ustad and Vidwan and Pandit, I am handling an abattana vastu. But let me indulge my fancy for just one more moment. If Vidwan, the word, has acquired the characteristics of Pandit, Ustad has also acquired a secondary attribute, which is not just teacher who can transfer skills, but as being somebody who's very, very sharp. And Ustad has wisdom, but also wisdom's street smart cousin, which is the sharpness to tell the true from the fake, the artist from the artful, the scholar from the pretender to scholarship. And Ustad is nobody's fool, and rather more than the Vidwan, he has a great sense of laughter and of fun. Chalapati is the Vidwan who is also an Ustad. In his mastery of the history of our subcontinent's south, the politics of that area, especially the Tamil part, with an emphatic coloration, reds and blacks sought to be demarcated now with a self-inserting white, and now joined very assertively by blues, Chalapati has mastered the chromatic history and geography of our south. He has need and he has the skill to be, for the whole of the world and India in particular, the Vidwat and the Ustadi of a historian who is also a political scientist, but more than anything else, a serious observer of how the human psychology works and reacts to political challenges. Speakers have spoken of their favorite books. Among my favorite examples of Chalapati's books are all the books I have known are fantastic books, but his translation of Bharati's letters to the editor of the Hindu, so appropriately represented here today by Nirmala Lakshman, is a strong favorite. Consider Chalapathy's gentle dig. Now, Ram Guha will particularly appreciate this. We all know of the collected works of Mahatma Gandhi. We keep saying collected works of Mahatma Gandhi. Professor Swaminathan's fantastic work, collected works of Mahatma Gandhi. Now best known by the four initials CWMG, CWMG, CWMG. Now if you just observe that, collected works of Mahatma Gandhi and the Sukhgal, the Avatar of Sukhgal, you just observe it. I distinctly recall Rajaji saying once, how can they call this the collected works of Mahatma Gandhi? You can have collected works of Shakespeare, of Tennyson, of Milton. They wrote works. You can collect their works. But these are letters, comments, speeches, editorials. He did not write works. How can you call them collected works? He was right. But nobody else has quite said it. But in this book, Bharati's letters to the editor of the Hindu, on the verso page in the colophon, Chalapathy describes that book as what? As the uncollected writings of C. Subramanya Bharati. I think that is an absolutely fantastic correction to the huge ego behind the naming of that monumental collection, collected works, the uncollected writings of C. Subramanya Bharati. In his rendering of Bharati's English words, Chalapathy is a master. Bharati was a master of the English language, something I learned after reading those letters. Bharati may have had some help, maybe he did not have help. But in any case, those letters in English of Bharati are something else. How has Chalapathy translated Bharati's letters, English letters, into Tamil? Now there is this famous letter which Bharati writes about Shankaran Nair's statements. Bharati is completely in admiration of Shankaran Nair. Mr. Shankaran Nair says, Chalapathy, if translating that, Mr. Shankaran Nair would have started by saying, Thiru Shankaran Nair. No. Chalapathy has so interiorized the situation. He makes Bharati say, Sriman Shankaran Nair. Now, Bharati would not in his mind have said anything other than Sriman Shankaran Nair. But he had translated it into English. Chalapathy is reversing and returning the translation in Bharati's mind into Bharati's language as Bharati would have spoken in 1904. It is in Chalapathy's choice of Sriman for Mr. that his genius lies. Give that line to anyone to translate into Tamil, she or he would have probably used Thiru Shankaran Nair. But Chalapathy knows this is Bharati writing. C. Subramanya Bharati, son of Lakshmi Amman and Chinnaswamy Subramanya Iyer, husband to Chellamma. That man composing that line would have said Sriman. Let me assume for the moment, without the benefit of corroboration from Chalapathy, that he shares the ideas of his clear and unambiguous historical favorite Periyar on the subject of God and the rest. Let me assume that. I find it vidvat and ustadi of the highest order that when translating Bharati's rather unconvincing 1919 lecture titled Cult of the Eternal, Chalapathy sets aside his own views, whatever they may be, totally on the subject of God and creation, and enters Bharati's mind completely. Chalapathi excels himself in the Tamil translation of Bharati's original words. What are Bharati's original words? Injure none. He ends his speech, lecture, by injure none, love all. And that is how the Hindu reported the last line of Bharati's lecture. Yevarium tunpuruttadi. Yevarium tunpuruttadi. Yellarumilum anbu seluthuva. This is Chalapathi's version, but it is Bharati's mind. These are Chalapathi's words, but it is Bharati's thoughts. That could be a national motto. The poet could not have done better. A translation is not just about faithfulness. It is also about sharpening the point, sharpening it to a fineness, a sharpness, a point beyond which it cannot be sharpened, like the refining of a pencil's lead tip to its ultimate potential of pointedness beyond which the point will break. In Bharati's letter of 19 October 1916, advocating English as a secondary medium of instruction, the poet says, as reported in the Hindu in English, "I think that any rational Englishman ought to be satisfied with this concession." English as a secondary medium of instruction. Bharati said, "I think any rational Englishman ought to be satisfied." For once, I think Chalapathi has felt that this is too soft. For this highly polite line, Chalapathi gives, "Buddhi ullai endra English karam." Buddhi ullai endra English karam. Bharati said rational, not intelligent. But thank God for the Ustad in Chalapathi for rescuing Bharati's courage from Bharati's courtesy. Chalapathi's latest book, which Ram spoke of, Tamil Characters, shows this unique skill. He says in it, for instance, "From Subramanya Bharati and A. Madhavaya to Sundara Ramaswamy and Gyani Shankaran," and then within brackets, "and T.M. Krishna, Tamil Brahmins have produced a host of self-critical intellectuals." I read that sentence, I reread it, I read it many times. What were those brackets doing there? Why is T.M. Krishna alone in brackets? I plucked up courage and asked Chalapathi. And he said, very simply, "Because all the others in that sentence are no more, Krishna is the only one amongst us who is still." I could see that that was Ustad's answer. I do not really know whether that is the full answer. That line about a poet, Bharati, two novelists, Madhavaya and Sundara Ramaswamy, and Chalapathi puts in Krishna there within brackets for the reason, I think, that in that list of honorable self-critical Brahmins, Krishna is a relative newcomer. And so maybe he should be like a learner's plate on a driving car. He should be put in brackets. It is too soon to call him self-critical yet. But then I think Chalapathi felt, no, maybe that is not quite right. You see, after all, though he is still young and still so early into self-criticism, he is the most unconditional and severe self-critic of the whole lot. So I cannot not have him. So I think between should I include, should I exclude, he chose to put the name in brackets. Now brackets are a punctuation mark. Punctuations are part of language, but they are part of the script of a language. They are not part of spoken language. You cannot speak a bracket. You cannot enunciate a comma. You cannot vocalize a semicolon. But like in dance, abhinaya is silent, But eloquent punctuations are silent and eloquent. Let me go beyond that line and beyond the bracketed T.M. Krishna to say that Chalapathy is a master in the use of punctuation marks in his writing. You open any page and you will find the use of the bracket and the M dash, the long dash, reinforcing his meaning, connecting thought with thought, and enriching the narrative. And brackets are also a metaphor. The inclusion of somebody from the side, so to say, is a great service to the narration. Take the book on Bharati's copyright. The book is about Bharati, but almost within metaphorical brackets and within imaginative M dashes, he brings in other characters. Suddenly, the scene shifts from Bharati and Chalamma. It moves to AVM. If Bharati is known as greatly and emphatically and with volition and voltage as he is known today, I think it's because of the music that has carried his words. And AVM. AVM just comes to life in that book. And Avinashalingam Chettiar, a name forgotten. Chalapathy's brackets and dashes bring in to the center stage those who may otherwise have been on the margins. The South is a metaphor. When one speaks of the South globally, one speaks of that part of the world which has not received the attention it deserves. Chalapathy's South is much beyond the South of India. It is the South that covers and includes and brings to the center all that is in the margins. And there is one character in that book who just sprang to life in my mind, the Bharati book, the copyright book, Omandur, Ramasamy Reddy. I learned from that book, incidentally, almost in a bracket, that Omandur was a classmate of Sri Ramana Maharshi. And Chalapathy does not have this in his book, but it reminded me of the fact that Omandur was a very shrewd judge of men and of human situations, exactly as Chalapathy is. When as chief minister, he got 2-3 years in a row a proposal for a certain officer's extension after retirement. முதல் தரம் சரின்னு சொல்லிவிட்டார். ரெண்டாவது தரம் சரி சரி போகட்டும்னு சொல்லி. மூணாவது தரம் அவருடைய எக்ஸ்டென்ஷன் மறுபடியும் ப்ரப்போசலில் வரும்போது ஓமாந்தூர் ரோட் அந்த ஃபைல். அவர் செத்து போயிட்டா. நான் ஓமாந்தூர் ஃபேண்டாஸ்டிக் இன்டெலெக்ட் ஹஸ் பின் இன் தி ஷேட்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி மெட்டஃபாரிக்கல் சவுத். Chalapathy has brought him to the fore. I will round off by saying Chalapathy is also, while being a master of the hyphenated punctuation mark, master of another punctuation mark, which is the double word, double barreled punctuation. I love Chalapathy's line in characters. Jayamohan's and S. Ramakrishnan's transition to full-time writing has been cross-subsidized by their work in the film world. Cross-subsidized, hyphenated double barrels. Cross-subsidized is entirely Chalapathy's creation. And my goodness, how completely it describes that transition. There is something called leaving the rest to the reader's imagination. Ustad. Chalapathy admires a few, dislikes many, absolutely loves some. C.S. Subramanyam, Pudumai Pittan, M.L. Thangappa, of course, Perumal Murugan. Chalapathy's concluding line in the piece on Murugan, in that book, is the following. Chalapathy's words, the controversy around Perumal Murugan, the controversy has become a wound, it can at best become a scar. It cannot go away. That line is what makes Chalapathi who he is. That great line needs to be done into Tamil, for I know Chalapathi thought of it in his mind in Tamil. What would that line be? It can best become a scar. It cannot go away. Only Chalapathi knows how that can be said in Tamil. Only Perumal Murugan knows what it is to be that. And only Krishna can sing it in a Viruttam. Or to borrow from the Rig Veda, Chalapathi may know how to say that in Tamil, but perhaps even Chalapathi may not know. A student of students, a teacher of teachers, a writer of writers, Chalapathi is a nugget of gold in our times of leaden beliefs, adherences, and servilities. No thought travels without a word or signs. No word moves without speech or writing. No writing without ink. No ink without a printer. The works of Chalapathi are inseparable from the world of Kala Chuvalu, which is nothing else today than Kannan Sundaram. What Frank Kermode and Carl Miller were to the Times Review of Books, Chalapathi has been to Kala Chuvalu. And what the TRB has been for them, Sundaram Ramaswamy and Kannan Sundaram have been to Chalapathi. The greatest thing about Chalapathi is that when he supports in a way in which he can never be co-opted. When he adheres in a way in which he reserves the right to critique what he is adhering to today. You have had too much of English. You are lucky I have not inflicted my Tamil on you. But this I will say, that Chalapathi udaya chintanein meyum and the meyum ka Kannan Sundarathin meyum kalandhu innikku nammude periya saubhagyam. Thank you.
Chalapathiyin ezhuthukalai நமது கண் முன்னால் கொண்டு வந்து நிறுத்தினார். ஜலபதியின் நிறுத்த குறிகளும் பேசும். உண்மைதான், மாமணியை பற்றிய ஒரு குறிப்பு எழுதியிருந்த போது மாமணி என்று ஒரு ஆச்சரியக்குறியை போட்டார்.